Welcome to Share Truth, Apply Scripture. I'm Jordan Chambly, joined by Wesley Wildman and Cedra Sarton. And today we're going to talk about stuff.
Stuff.
Yeah. And just that's not me just being lazy. We're actually going to talk about stuff. We're going to talk about how much is too much? Can it get in the way of important things? And why do we accumulate so much stuff? Hmm. So materialism, basically. So let's talk about the American dream for a second. We're all familiar with that. It's the big house, the big salary, early retirement, 2.5 kids, beautiful spouse, big yard.
I'm still trying to figure out how someone has 2.5 children.
Yeah, well, I'm sure you can be creative.
Thank you for pointing that out, Cedra. I was wondering the same thing.
Yeah, but this is something that
a dog.
Yeah, well, there you go.
An animal.
Yeah, that's 0.5 kid, right?
No.
Okay.
No.
You can be divided about that. But this is stuff that we've been kind of sold from birth. That, through commercials, through advertisements, things that we've been saturated with telling us, you need this thing.
And it be the final, mm-hmm. and it kind of be the final product of your strategy of what you think is an accomplishment in your life.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of like, yep.
Like, you need this to be complete.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, hey, I've got the newest model car. Mm-hmm. It's got the complete package and totally, all the safety features, the backup camera. So I must be doing well in life, right?
Yeah, exactly. And a lot of people, who was it? I think it was Jim Carrey, actually, who said it, that he wishes that people could achieve all of their dreams and get as rich as they want so that they realize that it won't make them happy.
Mm-hmm.
Which is really, really, I think that's an important thing to realize.
Well, we've seen an uptick, and mm-hmm. I don't want to bring down up a really sad subject.
Okay.
But it seems to be in the news, dominating the news, celebrity suicide.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And some of the most well-known, the celebrities, they're well-known, wealthy, obviously have made money and mm-hmm. made a name for themselves, and yet they're not happy. Why mm-hmm. is that?
Yeah.
So.
Well, I think as we continue to discuss this topic, and we'll do so in a couple of different ways, mm-hmm. And we'll come to a conclusion we think is a biblical conclusion here. But as we walk through these things, just a reminder, we're not saying any of these things in and of themselves mm-hmm. are bad things.
Yeah.
Are good, and
definitely.
A lot of them are good things, but mm-hmm. the misuse of them and the misplace mm-hmm. of them and your identity is what we'll be focusing on.
Yeah, definitely.
It's not necessarily a bad thing to have the newest model car or a nice house or anything like that, but...
Yeah, it's the realization these things won't make you happy. And we just kind of cut to the end of the episode, right? We could end. But let's talk about how we get to this point where, so have we ever bought stuff? I'm sure we have.
Sure.
Have we ever bought stuff that we've regretted? And we were like, afterwards, we're like, why did I get that?
I suffer from buyer's remorse weekly.
Weekly?
Uh-oh.
Okay.
Good episode for procedure.
It's not, here's the thing. I just can't. Okay, mm-hmm. I'm going to tell people my obsession. I have a makeup problem.
Oh,
there you go.
Okay.
I see a new lip color, a new eyeshadow come out. I get the emails from all the different big chain makeup stores.
Right.
And I'm like, I have to have
you have to
the
have
thing.
It.
I'm going to be honest with you. I have a new eyeshadow palette on its way.
Yeah.
I've been keeping track of the delivery.
Mm-hmm.
But all the time I'll buy stuff like that and I'll go, but did you need it?
Right.
Yeah.
But in the moment when I'm buying it, I needed it.
Oh, yeah. You need it until you get it, and you're like,
I said for me, I don't need makeup.
No.
You're a handsome man.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe a little,
don't need that.
Little concealer.
just a little bit? Okay.
I'm just kidding.
No, we don't want to cover up rugged good looks.
That's right.
All right, let's move on to the next part.
I've done this many times. Like, I have, especially in my teen years, when I started making money, I was like, okay, so I'm a nerd. I see this thing on a website, a replica sword from the Lord of the Rings movies. I have to have it. I've got to have it. I just need it, to be a complete nerd, to really say that, yes, I am a Lord of the Rings fan.
Mm.
I have to have this hanging above my bed.
There you go.
which is funny because as soon as I put it above my bed, I was like, this is not a good idea.
Right.
Do you have one?
I do. I'd have multiple.
Yes.
That sounds about right.
I have multiple.
As another friend that we know also.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I haven't really decided what I'm going to do with them. They're in a closet right now, just like sitting
hiding
there,
from your child.
Like by the water heater. Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I need to do something with that. But anyway, so we accumulate these things, and they seem to kind of invade. After a while, we look up and we see ourselves surrounded by this stuff. Mm. And has, in y'all's experience, has any of that like gotten in the way of anything meaningful? So you have all these things, maybe the maintenance of something takes away time from something else that's probably more important.
Well, I think for me, I made these, I like the word you use, buyer remorse.
Yeah.
You know, once I, you know, started, you know, working part-time, I become making my, you know, high school and start making my own money, that thing. Through that, you know, there was a lot of freedom in there for me to, you know, there were certain things I needed to pay for them on. There were other things that I had freedom to purchase and get for myself. And it was through that process, you know, I had a couple buyer remorses here or there. And through that, I learned early on, and look, if I didn't need it, you know, I had to make a couple mistakes on my own. But I think, you know, I begin to really think through the need of it, you know. And then at the same time, I'm not one that's no fun in the sense that I do have hobbies and that I invest in those areas, which in return in those hobbies, I do things that glorify the Lord as far as using my hobbies as a way of discipleship and fellowship. So so I really, and then on the other hand, you think about what Paul said in Philippians that he understood, he had been through on both sides. He understood what it meant to have a lot and he understood what it meant to have a little. He's been through both circumstances and he understands that Christ and his relationship's the most important. And so for me personally, I want to say that in this particular area, I matured really early, a lot early on.
Right.
And so by the time I'm a full adult and I'm married with kids, you know, I end up being the money guy in the household. So.
Well, I was thinking about this program, the verse that was sort of like the centerpiece. I'm horrible with where things are in the Bible. You're really good at that. So lay up for yourselves. Don't lay up for yourselves treasure on earth.
Yes.
Lay for yourselves treasures in heaven.
Yes, that's going to be in the Gospels. I know that much. But
okay,
I can't
it's in the Gospels. You know what? If you want to find it, just read the whole thing.
Yeah.
Just type it into Google. It'll pop right up.
But let's think about that for a minute. Don't lay up for yourself treasures on earth, but lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven. The word treasures there, because obviously the Bible's not teaching us that you shouldn't buy things and you shouldn't invest for the future. Yeah. Treasure is different than things that you need. Treasure is different than even things that you enjoy sometimes, like good stuff that God gives you to enjoy. Treasure is something that I feel like it's something that you set on a high place. Like it's very special. It's set apart from everything else you have. It's something that you want to like keep like for yourself, and it's part of almost like your identity.
Mm-hmm.
None of these things. A common phrase is you don't take anything with you when you die.
Right, yeah.
You won't take any of these things with you. So thinking of these things...
Only so much can fit in the casket, right?
Yeah, right. So, exactly. And most of that is just you. Just you. But what are treasures that we can begin laying up for ourselves in heaven on earth?
Mm-hmm.
I can think of relationships.
Yeah.
That's exactly what first popped in my head.
Yeah. Because we have families. We all have families. Close relationships with your families, with your friends, and with other believers. Things that will, these things are glorifying to God as we are Christians because He's working through us into other people's lives. And cultivating a close relationship and a meaningful relationship with these people, that is laying up real treasure, lasting treasure. In heaven.
Well, no, I was going to say something about that because you think about treasure in heaven, that implies that there will be rewards, you know, for our
that is true.
Behavior and our actions on this side of heaven. And, you know, this can almost go without saying, but I mean, the things that we do on this side of heaven, we're going to be rewarded, but we do them because of our love for Christ and what He's done for us on the cross. But the reality is we will be rewarded when we get to heaven for the things. And then, you know, we'll be judged for the things that we should have done that we didn't. But it's important for us to take note of this. And as we move forward, you know, making sure that all the things we do, whether it's in our actions or in our deeds, is prioritized and is brought under the submission of our relationship with Christ.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, when you were talking about relationships, though, that kind of, I've thought often, and it's one of the things that got me to quit, going back to the makeup thing, quit spending, like, I still like to buy it, but I don't focus so much on taking the time, put it on, because I'm a perfectionist when it comes to that.
Right.
I have to sit on, and I have to do the whole, it's all or nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't have a 5-minute routine, but I've been thinking about all the time that I've spent doing that and not spending, you know, on other people.
Mm-hmm.
I have more time to spend and talk to, like, my little brother or something, or my little sister in the morning. Sometimes, you know, talking to them. My little sister's married and moved out now. It's a little harder, but spending time talking to my brother, if he'll talk to me, that's a different matter. But, you know, I have more time to talk to other people and, you know, hey, good morning, how's it going? Maybe sit down if they're in the same room.
Mm-hmm.
And even just stealing little moments like that.
Mm-hmm.
I've noticed that if I move the whole makeup routine out of the way, just that little thing gives me more time to building things.
Well, there's like so many polls and so many memes out there where you see the lack of relationship building, especially for our generation down because of all the technology. I know that at this point that's almost like, you know, everybody says that, but
there's an issue there.
There's an issue, but the reality of that actually taking place and the consequences of less interaction with people, there has been and will continue to be serious consequences if we don't making building relationships important.
Yeah.
Because we have to have the latest, newest, everything. You can do everything on your phone. Which is supposed to be for communication, but it's the worst thing for communication, to be honest. Like you spend time building up, and I gotta say, when I went to get the phone that I have, I wanted the latest, newest. That's what I got. And I guess maybe learning to limit myself on all of those things and the things here on earth. It's what I'm really trying to get at, focus on.
No, that's good. Yeah.
Yeah, we're going on a mission trip because I've been to places in Mexico where their houses are. We have barns here that are better than their houses.
Yeah, you start putting things into perspective.
Yeah, it does.
All right. Well, thanks for listening, and stay tuned for the next segment. We're going to turn it on its head and talk about laying up treasures in heaven, and we hope to see you there.